they only show up in these discrete quantized orbital regions.
And then another higher mode here. The ring doesn't vibrate unless I give it some specific energy input.
Now you can take these electrons out by shining light at it. But to get the ones at the quantized states toward the center of these, you need high energy light, like it creates a gift.
Originally, we thought this gift is outrageous. The so-called blood explosion, which punctuates the conclusion of Akira Kurosawa's 1962 movie Sanjuro, remains one of the most memorable and influential special effects in film history. Production designer Yoshiro Muraki would later recall this scene was filmed in a single take. No such effect had ever been attempted before, as movies at the time rarely showed violence with graphic detail. Filled with uncertainty, Muraki worried the blood spray he'd rigged about Tredulon the skateboarding wizard and his rad crew of individually named skateboard goblins. You wanna know my favorite spell of
Minecraft?
Thank you.
themselves.
Of course there are.
Single, recently single, recently divorced, lesbian who will let me watch.
You could not be more evil.
Sorry, five. Recently widowed. So I'm talking to this girl. I'm sure he's in a better place.
You know, your new D&D character's starting to look eerily familiar.
Really? What makes you say that?
Well, it says here that you'll be playing a warlock with an undying patron.
Yeah, so after a terrible accident caused by my parents, I was left forever changed, capable of channeling the unholy powers of the dead. So now I stand as a bridge between the material plane and the depths of hell, and use these fantastic powers to do battle with an ever-encroaching army of spirits.
Jesus Christ. I'm not playing Jesus.
No, that's not what I... Just keep talking.
Okay, well, I don't have to go it alone. Alongside a snarky rogue and a clumsy but well-meaning artificer, we do everything we can to reverse the mistakes of my parents and defend our small town from supernatural threats.
Threats like what exactly?
Well, there's an angry lunch lady, a genie, incel, and a blue-collar worker who we bully a lot.
What?
Oh, there's also just, like, an insanely hot cop woman, too.
Okay, well, tell me more about your patron.
Well, I decided to go a little less traditional with it. My patron is actually inhabiting my body after the accident, and I was forever bonded with an undying entity that grants me these powers.
Are you playing Danny Phantom?
Well, he is much more unique than the other guy.
You know, your new D&D character's...
Not on medication right now. Who is out here just raw dog?
Wow, this My Hero Academia show's pretty good.
Yuji? This pizza place came up with a playful challenge for its customers. Lift a slice and stretch the cheese all the way up the chart without it breaking, and you win a free pizza. And watching how far this woman manages to stretch the cheese is awesome. Take a look.
It is said that in a traffic accident, a surfboard can fly off the roof of a car and crash through the windshield of an oncoming vehicle, causing death. Mythbusters conducted an experiment. They would tow a car carrying a surfboard with a cable and have it collide with another car at a speed of 40 miles per hour to see if the surfboard could fly and...
How did you even find me?
Oh, simple. I attuned a dowsing dagger to your specific energy. I followed it from there.
I thought time travel was weird.
Oh, you were not wrong about that, though. Blimey. This is one out of a jam jar you got here.
I thought we gave the Englishman to the time pigs.
That was Rip. This is John Constantine.
Scathed Brit in a trench coat. Same thing.
Oh, doubtful, mate. You see, I am an accomplished warlock, an expert of the occult, and a master of exorcism. I'm also a Taurus, for those of you taking notes. The Anansi totem, that belongs to...
Her granddaughter. Same totem, different vixen. She's from 1942, you were saying about the warlock thing.
Accomplished warlock, mate. Well, I am charmed to know another who bears the family name.
It's an honor.
So, what's your story then, Anson?
I'm from another Earth, and I'm spoken for.
Yeah, his girlfriend's a guy. Anyway, this is too much for me. I watch TV.
How did you even...
You know, your new D&D character is starting to look eerily familiar.
Really? What makes you say that?
Well, for starters, it says here that you're playing a monk who was the last surviving member of their people after a horrible dictator laid waste to their lands in the name of preserving their rule. Yeah, so one of my parents actually sacrificed themselves to ensure my survival, sending me to a distant land. And it says here that you're raised by a kind old man before you leave home in the hopes of pursuing martial arts, one day becoming one of the most powerful hand-to-hand combatants in the entire world, harnessing the power of a mighty dragon to enact miracles and bring about peace. However, this garners the attention of that same dictator. Yeah, so they're this maniacal ruler with a white and purple color scheme who supplements their forces with advanced technology, who then, after a long and arduous battle, spurs my character on to achieve power beyond anything they thought possible.
Uh-huh.
But it's only after learning to harness his ki and realizing a centuries-old prophecy that he undergoes an incredible transformation, bathing my character in golden light. And then I'm assuming in a following adventure you do battle with a psychopath wielding the combined might of your friends and foes?
Yeah, how did you know?
Because you're playing Goku.
I'm actually not.
Then who are you?
Kung Fu Panda.
You know, your new D&D character...
Battle Bane gets to think.
With no fish people, it explains why they hate the sun.
Stop talking brain thinking.
It's the school thing.
Stop talking brain thinking.
I don't know why they got this place locked down so tight. Here, take a drink. There's practically no way he could get in here. We got guards on every single entrance.
light and notices some malfunctioning in the bulb, so it turns off. Its battery also starts dying, so it turns on its spare lamp to stay alive.
Right, Jack, here we go. Now, we got this guy. He invented himself a little vault for the beach, so when you're out in the water, swimming around, you don't have to worry about thieves coming over and stealing all your valuables.
Sometimes when every second counts, the smartest thing you can do is play safe. In a group stage matchup between Cloud9 and SK in Katowice 2018, C9 were getting kind of walloped and needed to win their second round run. After a hectic late round B execute that went very south very fast, Automatic was the last C9 player standing in a 1v3. He fragged his way up site and got the bomb. But Automatic was very low, had literally zero bullets in his AK and couldn't reload because it would give off a sound cue. So he pulled out his USB, and instead of going down swinging, he just threw a smoke at his feet and stood still. Since Taco had no armor, a single headshot from the USB would be enough to secure the round. And lo and behold,
he's giving a lot of time away to Automatic, who's staying in the
smoke.
That's quite good!
And the rifle throw to distract Taco? That's the BM cherry on top. Sometimes when...
This is why you should never enter a random cave hole without checking first. A cave in Costa Rica is one of nature's death traps. When a man waved a lit torch in the upper part of the cave, nothing unusual happened. But as soon as the torch was moved closer to the ground, it instantly went out. This occurs primarily because the concentration of carbon dioxide is too high at the bottom of the cave. So, if you encounter such a cave, it's crucial not to venture in recklessly, as it could be extremely dangerous. This is why you should never enter a random cave hole without checking first.
Why did nobody tell me that the spell Mage Hand is the most powerful spell in all of D&D? First of all, it's barely a spell, and an inoffensive one at that. It doesn't deal any damage, and even if it could, it states you can't make attacks with it. Yeah, but it also states that a spectral hand appears at a point I choose within range rather than a point I can see, which means that it doesn't require a line of sight. It doesn't state how big the hand has to be. People just assume it's the size of a regular hand.
I fail to see your point.
Well, with all that in mind, I'm going to summon the Mage Hand inside of someone.
And do what exactly? You can't attack with it, and according to rules as written, shoving and grappling does in fact count as an attack.
So I may not be able to give them the raw spectral fisting I had originally intended, but I do have other options.
Really? Like what?
Staying completely still.
What?
Well, say that when I cast Mage Hand, I decide to make it roughly the size of a quarter.
Uh-huh.
And rather than attempting to play patty cake with their internal organs, I simply summon it inside of an artery that pumps oxygenated blood to the brain, which would in turn cause a clot and give them the BBG a stroke. Why did nobody tell me that this...
I can't find my staff.
You fucking what?
I lost my staff.
Don't you lose me that fucking thing!
Where's my staff?
Yeah, I don't have mine either.
Mine's missing too.
Yeah, he lost.
I had it a second ago, and I don't know.
How'd you lose a giant staff?
It's almost 6 feet long.
I shrunk it a little bit too much, and it both fell out. So you want us to just fight with our hands?
Not about damn time.
Yeah, I didn't call you to fight.
Is the supercharge worth it, or...
You're like her. Dude, you're being crazy.
Here's the difference. You have a block of frozen H2.
Devil Went Down to Georgia is fascinating to me, because it's so American. In any other culture, it would be a cautionary tale of hubris and fooling with the demonic. But in America, Johnny actually is just better than the devil. It's so American.
No, I'm a whole pack of phantom demons!
I done told you once, you son of a gun, I'm the best that's ever been.
He is a liar, as you say?
Well, absolutely.
Why don't you work for him?
Welcome to Rick's Naming Services. What's your business?
Plumbing.
What's your first name?
Oh, Steve.
Steve, you are now Steve's Plumbing. Next.
I'm also a plumber named Steve.
What's your last name?
Olson.
Olson Plumbing. Next.
We own a concrete business.
What's the first initial of your last name?
M&H.
M&H Construction.
I have a concrete business, too.
You guys pretty good?
Yeah.
Would you say that your work is quality?
Yeah.
Quality concrete! Moving on!
LA Tile.
Spice this one up a little bit. Where are you located?
Fargo, North Dakota.
Fargo Tile, next.
I also lay tile in Fargo.
Top one. You got anything close to your shop?
River.
Red River Tile, next!
You are not gonna f***ing believe this, but I also lay tile in Fargo by the river.
Oh yeah, actually that one is pretty tough. What's your favorite cardinal direction?
South.
Southtown Tile. Next.
Yeah, no, I don't...
Butters, you're not looking at boobies again, are you?
No, Dad, I'm not looking at boobies.
What's up, guys? This is
it was a combo tuna meatball sub.
That's my favorite! Oh, I knew Jerry wouldn't forget! They called that the Goblin Surfing Tip.
What the hell is going on out here?
Oh. Sorry, sir. He
They broke through the security cordon downstairs.
Only because they would have let me up without an appointment.
But how does a regular guy get an appointment with the mayor anyway? Anyone thought you need anyone?
Thank you for not having me arrested back there. Those security guards really overreact. You know, one of them tried to mace me.
Dr. Haywood, I only agreed to give you 5 minutes, which was 3 minutes ago, because Ray and Sarah are friends of mine. But I don't know the first thing about any legends. Of course you do, because you're the Green Arrow. Excuse me. We're done here.
Look, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to drop a bomb on you like that. It's just, I've exhausted all my normal avenues, and you're the only person left who won't think I'm crazy.
You sure about that?
I'm a historian. I specialize in deductive historical reconstruction. In layman's terms, I'm a time detective, which I really don't have to be to look at a calendar to see 1 week after you came to this city, Robin Hood showed up.
What the
In the Harry Potter universe where paintings and images can interact with those looking at them, waifu pillows are probably a lot more interesting. I cannot believe you just casually posted this, like it was an okay thing to do. In the Harry
Doctor, what does it mean?
I don't know. Let's find out.
Ah! Whoa! Oh, that was quick. We surrender.
No, it's okay. We're not. We surrender.
She threatened me with a chair leg.
Who are you?
Oh god, we're back in reception.
We surrender.
I've never been threatened with a chair leg before. No, hang on, I tell a lie.
Did you just say it's okay, we're nice? Yeah. Okay, I need everyone to shut up now!
Pupils are dilated. They are surprised as we are. Besides which, if it's a trick, it'll tell us something.
Oh, you're good. Oh, she's good. Amy, with regret, you're fired.
What?
I'm kidding.
Why is it up to you to save us?
Quite a god complex you have there.
I brought them here. Didn't say it was their choice, but offer a child a suitcase full of sweets and they'll take it. Offer someone all of time and space, and they'll take that too.
All of time and space, eh?
And when we get out of this, I'll show you too.
I don't know what you're talking about, but whatever it was, I have a feeling you just did it again.
This ball is extremely sticky because it's coated with
Can I get two monitors where one is...
God shattered the flaming sword into three distinct pieces. Blade of Death.
Azrael.
The Medallion of Life.
Johnson's Bell, Malcolm.
And the key that binds them all together. It says that God entrusted the key to his favorite son. Try and attach your ring to this.
Brother.
Just do it and we'll confirm what we already know.
Brother.
That Father's favorite, despite everything that you have done, is and always has been you.
Look down. They entrusted it to you. Brother.
This means that I'm the favorite son.
Dad is manipulating us 6 ways to Sunday. But hey, what's new? At least we have it now. So, hand it over, brother. The sword's not going to ignite itself. Right, don't make me hurt you. Remember, you're not the angel you once were.
No, Lucy, you're right, I'm not. I just need a little time to process what it all means. God shattered the flaming sword.
Did you know that pro players used to die to enemy Molotovs on purpose?
But why?
Back in 2017, during the golden days of Counter-Strike, there was one gun that was dominating the meta, and that was the UMP-45. This gun used to be completely broken.
There's no difference between throwing men and women. What I mean by that is that there are anatomical differences between male and female bodies, which results in varying proportions, but the most fundamental skill when it comes to throwing the body is being able three-dimensional forms in perspective. As long as you understand perspective, you can draw whatever body type you want. So, if you're somebody who's good at drawing one body type but not any other, it's not because it's a completely different skill. It's just that you don't know what the characteristics are yet, so you have to spend some time researching that topic. There's no difference.
We're back in time.
Ow!
Sorry.
Ow!
Here we go.
Are you kidding me with this?
Hey, at least I'm from the future. I always know. His rules of engagement float like a butterfly, sting like a bee.
Look ridiculous.
Have you considered heels?
They've taken Amy. And our baby.
I can't be with him.
The rooks stare at each other, but it's white wedding. If you trade, even though the black king is on the back rank, there's just no way to get to him. And if you trade the other rook, well, it's the same issue. You can give a check, sure, but where is the checkmate? So you can't just trade the rook. But then you might be thinking, trying to checkmate the king like this, but if you just play rook h7 check, the black king just goes to g8, and after rook to g1, you're so close to checkmate, but
which way Black takes, it's simply checkmate on the back rank. Black just plays king to g8, and after rook to g7, king can't go to f8 because it's mate. So after king to h8, how does White checkmate in 3 moves?
If only I had a daughter of marrying age, I would gladly offer you her hand. Regrettably, that child was not mine. And yet she never showed any promise whatsoever. That's when I learned the horrible truth that I wasn't her real father. Please rest assured that unfaithful wife of mine has long since been executed, and you're in no danger of being subjected to her detestable presence. So don't you worry.
So you had evidence of her infidelity then?
As I've already told you, the child showed no promise, which stands as incontrovertible evidence that she couldn't possibly have descended from a chief disciple of Lavetia.
What a fool. His obsession with heredity is so far gone, he's convinced his children are predestined to be prodigies.
I was hoping you'd give me some of those lowly blob you're holding on to back in Notcha, so I could hunt them for sport, of course. Prince Wayne, is something the matter?
I was just making a quick calculation.
All right, in that case, good riddance, sort of lad!
Take the ball in the orange box. He's spinning the wrong way. Hold, hold, hold. One shape. Watch this.
Everyone has defaulted to the game's sacred
the end scope.
This type of triple shot crossbow makes more sense for hunting because you're trying to up your chances to get food, but against a human it makes more sense to concentrate the force of that to guarantee that you're gonna hurt a full-sized person. This type of
just turn around, my dudes. You're only a 7-minute walk.
away from the nearest fast food shop.
Dancer, putting your car on top of your wheels is the best stupid idea ever. Look, if you put an axle straight through your wheel, it's just rubbing, even though the outside of the wheel does this amazing thing where it moves without sliding. So here's what you do. You put your axle on the outside of the wheel. You make the wheel tiny, add some extra, and then you make the floor into a circle so your wheels don't escape. And voila, a ball bearing, which is used in each and every car. Putting your car on top,
it's said that just by covering a car with phone books, it can become bulletproof. Mythbusters decided to create a bulletproof car using phone books. After testing, they found that the car windows needed at least 5 phone books to be bulletproof, and to cover the entire car would require 900 phone books, weighing nearly 1.8 tons. However, the car could only support a load of 800 kilograms. Unable to bear this weight, they reduced the weight of the car, removed excess accessories.
Real question, why does Walmart put all the iron on the bottom shelf? Because if you have
sure.
iron, you stand up. Well,
what happens?
Hey, do you want some pizza?
Yeah, I'll have a slice.
A slice of pizza? I'll take one.
Guys, I think it's time for me to get new shoes.
Never mind.
What do you mean?
Can you push the button?
Do not touch that button.
Just give it a little push.
Don't push it. Push it. Don't listen to that. Don't push it. Don't even touch it.
Why can't I push the button?
Because whenever Barney sees a button, any button, he has to push it.
Sorry. Why are you so mad?
Because my rehearsal dinner was supposed to start 10 minutes ago. But instead of stuffing my face with hors d'oeuvres that I have been dreaming about for months, I am in a laser tag security office waiting for the police to arrest my fiancé for causing a disturbance.
Hey, you said fiancé. That's a good sign. What do you say we give that a button a play?
The thing is not obey the laws of physics at all.
Kids, there's a lot going on here that you don't understand.
Stark says you say that. He also said to go for your legs.
Homie flashed over a building using a block.
Let me explain.
So shout out to Cole. It's
been strange cameras in the Byzantium vault. I ripped it when I was aboard. Sorry about the quality. It's for a second.
It's something.
Yeah, it's an angel. That's covering his face.
Come to the angels before you.
Well, it's not about the angels. The scavenger's better supply.
WWE?
Oh, that's world something wrestling, right?
Yeah, it's wrestling, but real cool.
him, so you smashed him on the floor.
Yes.
So you and Veal just spent time together alone.
Yes.
Wrestling.
That doesn't mean
talking
it.
Talking about tacos.
No,
eating tacos.
On stream. It was on
wink,
stream.
Wink.
It was on stream.
It was on stream.
Yes.
Was this like on Fansly or something? If you get to pick your own daddy, who are you? When your car is frozen.
This is a closely.
Technophobes need to apologize for just put it in plain English, you stupid machine. Because, well, for one. The decline in accurate error messages in favor of simplicity has contributed to the rise of tech illiteracy, but also because now, whenever an app has a net connection error, it will pop up a box saying something like, "Ooh, oopsie, your super duper feed went poo-poo. We'll try again soon." Which, having said to me by a corporation, is about 8 million times worse than having to hear the word network. Give me 60 lines of error code that tell me in excruciating detail exactly which memory address fucked up. I want microsecond accurate interrupt calls. I want to be able to find the individual transistor that caused this issue and humiliate it in front of its peers. This pisses me off so much, like, please just tell me what's wrong. Oops, something went fucky wacky. But what?
On that which holds, the image of an angel becomes itself an angel.
When a tree falls into a river, one end sometimes absorbs
Now, this forces the waterlogged end to sink, while the lighter end pokes out of the water. This vertical log bobs up and down and is barely visible. If a boat hits one, they can rip through the hull like a missile, splintering wood and tearing metal with brutal force. The impact can be so severe that it compromises the boat's structural integrity.
This guy got challenged to use this impossible golf.
What are you doing? Do you want me to kill you?
Oh, you're not going to kill me.
Ow!
What happens if you drop a grenade?
I feel like Olive Garden would be a much more appropriate name for a Greek restaurant than a pseudo-Italian one. This is the first sacred mystery of the Olive Garden. Second sacred mystery, unlimited breadsticks. Valueless item in infinite quantity.
Number two, the gut shot. This one's really scary because a lot of people think maybe I got liver, maybe I clipped an artery. And then you go check your arrow and you got some stomach matter and it's real stinky.
Listen, I just want you to think. Do you think it's just a fancy word for changing your mind?
It's empty, isn't it? Those boxes. There's nothing in them. Just money.
Yeah.